At Next Games, we're constantly looking into new ways of creating gameplay. We know that with the great success of The Walking Dead: No Man's Land, that's definitely no easy task to take over. So the natural conclusion was that we need to look into augmented reality and location-based games. So we created The Walking Dead: Our World, where you can play with your friends and interact with the real world. It's amazing. You can see the walkers being part of the real life.
Entering the location-based games, we had to rethink our backend system and move from the cloud services classic architecture to the Microsoft Azure Service Fabric. Now, Service Fabric gives us the agility that we need to operate our games on a global scale. Instead of managing the servers, we can just run the services and scale them the way we want.
When we're working with the big names like The Walking Dead, it's really hard to predict how many players will join the game. So we just want to test the system before the launch to the max and see if it breaks, if it ever will break. Actually, I don't really know with how many hundreds of servers we'll be launching the game or which data centers we'll be providing first. But then again, on scalability, why would I care? It's all in cloud. It just scales.
As a matter of fact, performance is extremely important in location-based games because you are moving around. And on top of that, instead of being limited to levels, the whole planet is your playground.
Augmented reality and location-based games are very heavy on the devices. To make interaction faster and more reliable, we take everything out of the device and put it on the server side. This way, the players can enjoy the breathtaking gameplay.
When it comes to microservices, it's the combination that matters. We're using CosmosDB as a geo-replicated database to store the information of our players and locate them. We're using Service Fabric to orchestrate and handle the messaging between the services. And with Azure Function, we can even dynamically inject events into the game. Say, for example, we detect players in one specific location. We can send more walkers there almost in real time.
It's a new world out there. When you're creating cross-platform games with iOS and Android as your devices, with augmented reality, using Azure as your backend, and Microsoft development tools, it's all about the openness, which makes Microsoft the glue between all of these.